You guys have all stepped up. You've had teammates go down different nights, different times. How have you guys kind of filled those gaps? I mean, obviously you had great nights tonight. What's been kind of the mindset that's helped you guys rebound from having key guys out on any given night? Whoever wants to answer.
I mean, I feel like as a team, we always all stay prepared. If you look at our practices, it's really competitive. 1 through 12, we all come in the loop from David to Myles. And like when everybody's here, we just fulfill our roles. But if they need us to step up, we can all do that too.
You had another career two nights in a row. You feel like you're in that groove right now?
Oh, yeah, for sure. Like I said, you got an opportunity, just trying to make the most out of it. Keep working, like I said. I just feel like everything I've done in the dark is starting to come to light.
David, you also had a career high tonight. Your 4 three-pointers in the first half were really important because the team was kind of struggling. Can you talk about getting in a rhythm and shooting that way and how it helped the team?
I just knew in the zone there's going to be holes in the zone, so I just wanted to run to the open spots. I was just being prepared, every night, just being prepared. You never know when the team might need you. So tonight they need me, so I just got the job done and contributed to the win.
Myles, I was asking Coach about the technical free throws you took there in the second half. Were you kind of surprised when whoever was kind of came to you and told you you were the one to do it, and then you ended up hitting both?
Yeah, we got to the huddle and Cronin just said, the way you're playing, you get to shoot the free throws. And at first I was like, okay. And, I've been working on it, just went through a confidence and confidence, and I made them, and that was it.
Jaylen, Coach was talking about how he tells you to maybe not be aggressive on fast breaks, like, hey, lay it in, don't dunk it. Like, and he was worried when he took that fall when you dunked it. Is that very, very difficult to think about as you're going up for a breakaway?
Yeah, I mean, I'm just an aggressive player. Like, because he saw me on my head, obviously, I can't get hit again in the head. So it's kind of hard. I don't really be thinking. Like, you get caught up in the moment, you just shoot the ball, you're running up along the pelvis. You know what I mean? But later in the game, I calm down and just get off 2 feet. Just let the ball in.
And defensively, you had another good game on Brown. Can you talk about your work on him and how you made it tough for him?
I feel like it came from a lot of my teammates. I started off when we were switching a lot. Playing with Myles helps me out a lot because I know if I get beat, I have backside help. He's going to come block it from the backside or just wall up. So as a team, I feel like we did a really good job containing him, and I'm open to guarding him.
Jaylen, you guys kind of got off to a slow start there. Was it just kind of new lineup and everybody trying to get in, or were you doing anything on defense?
No, I feel like we just haven't seen the zones. Washington's zone is very up, very aggressive and stuff. But like when people like Dave start hitting threes, they started opening it, they started having to guard them and stretch it out, and then we can get into the middle and attack it inside out.
David, you kind of capped off that big run to start the second half with a couple of three-pointers. The first one was like 30 feet, and that got you your career high. And you were definitely celebrating with the crowd a lot there in the second half. Just kind of, what was going through your head there when you were kind of hot and hitting so many threes and really just enjoying the environment?
What was going through my head, just keep shooting them, just keep making the right play. You know, I knew if I didn't force it, the shots would still come. And if I keep moving the ball, passing the ball, I would be a threat by my passing and my shooting. So it's just playing the right way. That's what's going through my head.
Myles, what is your mindset when you go into these games? Is it more defense? Is it more offense? Is it more blocking shots? What are you thinking when you go into these games?
Just mentally, I just lock into the scout report and just whatever is really needed for that game. Like this game, they're not really that much of an inside team. They shoot a lot of threes, so you know, long rebounds was my biggest focus for today, and definitely boxing out that big dude. And on offensive rebounds, they play a zone, so like all the rebounding was going to be open on offense. So today's focus was rebounding for me, and I kind of just do what we need to do. So if we need box, we need rebounds, that's what I got to do. We posted up all day today to wipe out everybody so they get layups, and just do whatever I got to do to get the dub. That's kind of just the mindset going into the game.
Coach said he held Cody out for load management. How are you guys holding up during the stretch? You got four more coming, and he said he's taking it a little bit lighter, practices and stuff like that. How's that going, and how are you guys holding up?
It's going pretty good. You know, UCLA offers us many resources to recover and stay hydrated, stay healthy. So, you know, shout out to the staff for keeping us like focused on track. The coaching staff doing a really good job of paying attention to our bodies, but keeping us locked in and getting ready for next game, preparing.
All right, thank you guys.